Hi, this is Caroline, and I am the Data Analytics Specialist at Paladin Digital Marketing. In today's short video, I will be showing you where to look in your Google Analytics account to find your financial advisor website's top 5 key performance indicators, or KPIs. This is the data that will really give you an idea of how users are engaging and interacting with your site. I will first note that we are looking at a specific segment of data that we have designed to filter out bots and some other unreliable data that is not truly representative of the site's visitors, but we can discuss that at another time. That's shown here. I will also note that for this video, we are looking at the first quarter of 2021, but you can select any time frame you want by choosing your dates up here. Now, on to the top 5 KPI for a financial advisor website. The best place to view these is the page you see here. To navigate here, you'll want to go to Acquisition, All Traffic, and select Channels, and that will take you to this page. The first KPI we will look at is the number of new users. That's here, and it can further be broken down into the means that they found your website, shown here. This gives you an idea of how many new people are seeing your site for the first time. Generally, you want to see this number improving from month to month as your site gains traction and draws in more visitors. Another incredibly useful piece of information, and our second top KPI, is the percentage of organic traffic, which is shown in that breakdown below. Whether you're looking at total users or new users, the percentage of organic traffic will be shown here or here. This number represents high quality traffic to your site, since people who found your site organically were looking for something specific on the internet that brought them to your site. So these users tend to be more interested in the content your site provides, and they usually spend more time exploring your website. Our third top KPI is bounce rate, which you can find over here. And for this is a percentage that indicates how many users find their way to one of your web pages and then leave without ever visiting a second page on your site. Since you want people to spend more time on your site and visit multiple pages, the lower the percentage, the better. If you are seeing a bounce rate of 60% or higher, that could be an indicator that something on your site is not resonating with visitors, such as the website design, message, or how intuitive the navigation is. As you can see here, for this particular client, there's a little room for improvement. This brings us to our fourth top KPI, which is pages per session, shown here. This is the average number of pages a user visits on your website during a single session. RIA sites that are performing well typically see users interact with 2 or more pages when visiting the site. Anything less could indicate an issue with the website design or content. Our last top KPI is session duration, which is just to the right of that. This is how long people are spending on your site before exiting. Visitors to your website will form their first impression within 8 or 9 seconds, so it's important to make the right impression. An RIA site that is performing well should have an average session duration of 2 minutes or more, meaning that people are sticking around and exploring what your website has to offer. So there you have it, the top 5 KPI to evaluate for a financial advisor website. I hope this video has been helpful. For more information, contact the experts at Paladin Digital Marketing.